How well do you know our amazing egg-laying mammals, known as monotremes? There are only two kinds of this unique and ancient mammal left in the entire world, the platypus and the echidna, and we're lucky enough to have both here in Australia. So, how long have monotremes been around? Well, we need to go back in time quite a bit. Around 300 million years ago, amphibians and reptiles emerged from the water to also live on land. A few million years later, reptiles that were a bit mammal-like began to appear, but these still weren't mammals yet. It took another 80 million years for the first monotremes to split off from the mammal-like reptiles and become their own unique evolutionary branch. This is around the same time that dinosaurs began dominating Earth, but well before marsupials and placental mammals arrived on the scene. Because of their reptile-like features, biologists consider monotremes to be the most primitive mammals in the world. Most obviously, monotremes lay eggs, but they also waddle like a reptile, with legs on the side rather than underneath their body. And a number of their body systems are similar to a reptile, including how they pass their waste and how they mate. In fact, the word monotreme derives from Greek meaning single hole, if you know what I mean. Neither echidnas nor platypus have teeth. Instead, they have special grinding plates which they use to eat aquatic invertebrates or ants. In Australia today, marsupials are the dominant mammal group, but platypus and echidnas have survived all this time because their ancestors lived where marsupials could not follow, in the water. Because marsupial joeys need to stay in mum's pouch for so long, they would drown if mum went for a swim. So while marsupials established themselves on land and in the trees, the water remained the realm of monotremes. Today's echidnas don't live in water, but they are thought to have evolved from a platypus-like ancestor and later adapted to life on land. There are three species of echidna, the short-beaked echidna and two species of long-beaked echidnas that are only found in Papua New Guinea. All have long tongues to feed. There's just one surviving species of platypus, and it's only found on the east coast of mainland Australia and Tasmania, making it extra special. Platypus are pretty adaptable though, as they can thrive in everything from tropical streams to dams on farms in Tasmania. So while monotremes may be our most ancient living mammal group, they have spent millions of years evolving to have the many amazing features and adaptations that make them perfect for life today.